Natural gas, it is another fossil fuels along with coal and petroleum. Natural gas are also a non-renewable natural resource because it is in a limited amount and can be exhausted. That means that can be come to an end, just like coal and petroleum. So natural gas is a fossil fuel found deep under the earth between two layers of impervious rocks, either above or along with petroleum deposits. So natural gas is a type of fossil fuels that are found above or along with petroleum deposits, and it contains mainly methane, that is CH4, and the small amount of gases like ethane. Then we have the propane and butane. So these are the chains of alkane, that is the hydrocarbons. And it is an efficient and convenient fuel because it does not produce any ash or smoke on burning. It is highly flammable. It is supplied through pipeline. Such pipelines exist in Vadodara and some parts of Delhi. Natural gas is used for manufacturing many chemicals and fertilizers. In India, we have the vast reserves of natural gases in Tripura, Rajasthan, Maharashtra, and in the Krishna Godavari Delta. So natural gas is found above or along with petroleum deposit. Underline this line. And it contains mainly methane. Now come to the compressed natural gas. So compressed natural gas, CNG. So the small form of compressed natural gas is CNG, is a natural gas stored under high pressure. It is used as domestic and industrial fuel and is used in the manufacturing of black. It is an eco-friendly fuel as it does not emit harmful gases like oxide of nitrogen and oxide of sulfur, which pollute the environment. Thus, it has been increasingly used as a fuel to run automobiles and buses. So compressed natural gas is a natural gas stored under high pressure. Underline this line. And it is used as a domestic and industrial fuel and in the manufacturing of carbon black. So the use of CNG as a fuel has brought down the pollution level in Delhi. So air pollution has been reduced with the use of CNG gas, that is the compressed natural gas, because it does not contain the oxide of nitrogen and the sulfur, and it is an eco-friendly fuel. So that is about the compressed natural gas. Now coal and petroleum are on the verge of extinction. So fossil fuels are, as you know, that it is a non-renewable source of energy, and they are also called as exhaustible natural resource because it takes millions and millions of years to form the coal and petroleum. And since we human beings are continuously using these coal and petroleum, that's why we can say that the coal and petroleum are on the verge of extinction. So fossil fuels are non-renewable resource of energy. They take millions of years to be formed. Although over-extraction of petroleum may not cause any environmental problem, but its excessive use is causing some major environmental problems like global warming and the air pollution, etc. What is global warming? The global warming means the greenhouse gases which are increasing in the atmosphere, that is the carbon dioxide gas, the methane gas. So these are called as the greenhouse gas which causes the global warming. That means so much of heat, heat or warmth is occurs due to the these gases, that is the greenhouse gases. Petroleum is used all over the world, primarily for transportation. A large number of useful products are also made by using various fraction obtained from refining of petroleum. The rate at which we are using petroleum, the day is not too far when all petroleum reserves may become depleted. So it will result in energy crisis. Coal mining is reported to cause some major environmental problems. So methane, a greenhouse gas, is released after coal mining. So if get mixed with groundwater, it causes the water pollution. Coal dust is also harmful for human beings. It may cause various respiratory problems. The major consequence of its overuse is that it will be finished in the next 100 years because we have limited resources of coal. So that's why we say that the fossil fuels like coal and petroleum are on the verge of extinction. But how should we conserve these coal and petroleum? So go to the next page. Conservation of fossil fuels. So we have already discussed that fossil fuels are available in limited amount in nature. So the following steps should be taken to conserve the fossil fuels. Number one, we should use a renewable source of energy like wind energy, solar energy, hydro energy to fulfill our energy needs. A renewable source of energy cause no pollution and are unlimited. Number two, energy should be generated from biomass. What is biomass? By the decomposition of plants and animals in the forest. Since the plant do the photosynthesis with the help of sunlight. So in this way, the biomass is formed. Petrol and diesel can be saved by using the fuel efficient vehicles and machines by driving vehicles at a moderate speed. So we can save the petrol and diesel by using the fuel efficient vehicles and the machine, and also by switching off the engines of vehicles at traffic signals, by ensuring the correct pressure and by regular maintenance of vehicles. Next, using carpool. Carpool is a good way to reduce the consumption of fuels like petrol and diesel. What is carpool? Carpool means if we have to go, people have to go same distance, if one car is used by four or five man or people, that is called carpools. So walking, carpool is a good way to reduce consumption of fuels like petrol and diesel. And last, walking down to nearby places instead of going by a vehicle also helps to save fuel. So we can save fuel by avoiding not to go with the car or the other vehicles, either walk down, that means walk on foot to nearby places, so that we can save the fuel and also the pollution. So in this way we can conserve the fossil fuels like coal, petroleum, as well as the natural gas. And that's all. Come to the checkpoint. What is a natural gas? So natural gas is a fossil fuels that are formed above or along with the petroleum gas, petroleum. From where is the natural gas generally obtained? So natural gas is obtained just under the surface of the earth, that is above or along with the petroleum. And it can be collected with the help of pipeline. So natural gas is a form of compressed natural gas, that is the CNG. And it is used as an important fuels for cooking as well as for driving the vehicles. That's all.